Hello there. Thanks so much for playing this video. I'm so sorry I couldn't join you live, but I just wanted to send a greeting to you. I'm so glad that the message about embracing idleness and not constantly obsessively pursuing busyness and productivity has resonated with at least some of you. And I wanted to talk to you a little bit about how this becomes toxic, our quest for productivity. Many of the things that we do now that we think are saving us time, things like sending emails instead of calling, things like working very, very long hours. Those are things that psychologists call maladaptive coping strategies. In other words, these are strategies that we came up with to cope, to help us in some way. And they might even have worked when we first started them, but they since became toxic habits. So let's say, for example, that you've had a super long day, and this was a few years ago, and you had a super long day, and you were getting an email back from somebody, that one of your coworkers, and just in order to get it off of your plate and get it done, that's what you needed that day for your state of mental health, you shot off an email. And it accomplished what you needed right then. It only took you a few minutes, and you didn't have to deal with that coworker, and you went home, and it took care of your problem for that day. The thing is that over the years, most likely you kept sending an email instead of calling. And since email is not more effective as a communication tool, since email actually leads to miscommunication, we also know through studies that email exacerbates conflict. It leads to less cooperation. We are less cooperative and collaborative when we're in our emails. Email over time is not a great strategy. It may have been a good coping strategy right at first, but over time, it's actually doing worse for you than if you had just picked up the phone and called. This is a maladaptive coping strategy now. And there's a lot of these things in our lives. One of them is something like working super long hours. Maybe there was one day where you really needed to put in a lot of extra hours, and so you did it. Maybe that was an effective coping strategy that one time or a couple of times. But over time, when you keep going back to that, working longer and longer hours, it becomes a toxic habit. It starts wasting your time. It starts lowering your productivity, and it becomes a maladaptive coping strategy. My book lays out a number of these things that we're doing that we think are helping, but that are actually hurting us. The most important thing to remember, though, is that your brain is not designed to work all the time. The human brain does not persist. It doesn't just keep going. It pulses. In order to be healthy, in order to do its best work, it needs to alternate between focused work and idleness, focused work and inactivity. That rest, not only is it not laziness, it's not even inactive. Your brain is quite busy when it's not focused on a task. But this rest is actually an important part of your productivity. You need this in order to get things done. Not having this makes it more likely that you're going to make errors. It makes it more likely that you're going to get distracted, and it'll take you longer to get things done. This idleness is part of your work. It's part of how you get things accomplished. But even more importantly, it's part of how you stay healthy and sane and happy. So, again, I wish you the best with all that you're doing. My book's called Do Nothing. It doesn't literally mean do nothing at all. It just means don't be working all the time. All the best to you, and thanks.